In the last learning module, we learned about what parametrized curves are. In this learning module, we are working on doing calculus with them. So for example, let's look at our old friend, the cycloid. So we had the equation of the cycloid. In this case, I took the radius to be 5. And we have the reflector on the wheel of the bicycle. It's going up and down and up and down. At time 0, it's over here. By time 2 pi, it's worked its way over here. By time 4 pi, it's worked its way over here. Of course, the distance is 10 pi horizontally and 20 pi, but the time it takes is 2 pi. Okay, and we want to do some standard calculus problems, like finding the equation of the tangent line at a certain point. The point we're going to take is at time 5 halves, that's this point. We want to find the equation of that tangent line. And the second thing is we want to figure out what is the area under one span of the cycloid. So now if these were ordinary graphs, y equals f of x, we'd know how to do that. We'd find the tangent by taking a derivative, we'd find the area by taking an integral, and things are only slightly different when we're doing things with parametrized curves. So let's first look at slopes of tangent lines. We want to figure out what is dy dx. dy dx, by definition, is the limit of delta y over delta x. We take two nearby points, say a point here and a point here, and we draw a straight line between them, and we take the ratio of the rise over the run. And when you're taking a limit, you're allowed to divide the top and the bottom by delta t, and then you take the limit of delta y over delta t divided by the limit of delta x over delta t, and that just gives you dy dt over dx dt. So the slope dy dx is given by dy dt over dx dt. And we could also have gotten this result from the chain rule. Now, if we plug this in at time pi over 2, we get that this is the formula for x. And so the value of x is 5 pi over 2 minus 1, which is around 2.85. And the value of y is 5 times 1 minus the cosine of pi over 2. And we just take some derivatives. We know how to take the derivative of t minus sine of x. T minus sine of t. That gives us 1 minus cosine of t. We know how to take the derivative of 1 minus cosine. That gives us sine. And we discover that dx dt is 5 and dy dt is 5. And so dy dt divided by dx dt is 5 over 5. So our tangent line has slope 1. And then all we have to do to get the equation of the tangent line is we say, put it in point slope 4, y minus 5 is equal to the slope times x minus 5 times pi over 2 minus 1. And then we do a tiny bit of algebra, and we get that the equation is y equals x plus 10 minus 5 pi over 2, or x plus roughly 2.15. Okay. So the main thing that's calculus here is finding the slope of the tangent line. That's given by the ratio of the derivatives. And then once you have the slope, find the equation of the tangent line. That's pre-calculus. Okay, the next thing we want to do is we want to figure out the area under the curve. Now remember, the way that we get the area under the curve is we chop it up into a bunch of little slices. And we have to figure out the area of each piece. And let's see, the height of this piece is at a certain value, y, and the width of this piece was delta x. So the area of a slice is the height times the width, so that's y times delta x, and we're going to divide and multiply by delta t. So where you see a delta x, think of it as delta x over delta t times delta t. And as long as delta x is small, that's roughly the same thing as y times dx dt times delta t. So the area, we integrate, we add up all the little pieces and take a limit. So the sum of these things times delta t becomes an integral of this expression times dt. You wind up with an area that's the integral from the starting time to the ending time of y times the derivative of x dt. So let's see how that actually worked out for the cycloid. For the cycloid, we started at time 0. We ended at time 2 pi, and our equation for x was 5 times t minus sine of x. We just take the derivative of that and get 5 times 1 minus cosine. And y was also 1 minus cosine. You put them together, times 5. And you get the area is y times the derivative of x dt. And that gives us, pull the factors of 5 out, 25 times the integral of 1 minus cosine of t squared. And we do that by just multiplying it all out. 1 plus cosine squared minus 2 cosine of t. And then we use a trig identity to handle the cosine squared. We replace the cosine squared with 1 half plus 1 half of cosine of 2t. And that we know how to integrate 3 halves. We know how to integrate cosine of 2t. We know how to integrate 2 cosine of t. And we get the answer 75 pi. Which incidentally is exactly 3 times the area of the circle of radius 5. Curious fact. Next time, we'll do arc length and surface area.